All right, we're taking a quick look at the mechanics of engineering economics, featuring simple cash flow diagrams and a few basic cash flow relationships. The simplest situation of all is a singular item, in this case, a one-time expenditure of $15 million, launching a project with a lifetime of 15 years and a discount rate of 4%. It's super simple. There's no accounting of project benefits or what it costs to maintain the system, and no salvage value at the end. We'll use this only to demonstrate the mechanics of determining the equivalent uniform annual cost, and later, the equivalent future cost. So as to avoid the more cumbersome computations, I'll introduce the factor table associated with a discount rate of 4%. This published table contains columns for each type of factor of interest and rows according to the number of years, n equal 1 year, to n equal 30 years, 40 years, 50, 60, and 100 years. Here I've highlighted the row corresponding to n equals 15 years, the lifetime of the project. So to demonstrate, let's locate the factor that converts the singular present expenditure of $15 million to an equivalent uniform annual expenditure using the corresponding factor we read as annual given present, or A given P. Given the known value to the right of the line P, we can solve for the unknown value to the left, A, simply by multiplying, in this case by a factor equal to 0.0899. As shown here, 15 million times 0.0899 is equal to 1.35 million. Thus, we find that a one-time expenditure of 15 million at the start of year one is fully equivalent to spending 1.35 million each and every year for a total of 15 years. Next, let's locate the factor that converts the uniform series of annual expenditures to an equivalent singular future expense at the end of the life of the project, this time using the factor we read as future given annual, or F given A. We'll solve for the unknown value F by multiplying the known value A by a factor here equal to 20.0236. As shown here, 1.35 million spent annually times a factor of 20.0236 is equal to $27 million. Thus, we find that the uniform series shown here is fully equivalent to a single future expenditure of $27 million. Finally, let's locate the factor that converts a singular future expenditure to an equivalent singular present expenditure, this time using the present given future factor shown here equal to 0.5553. Confirm that 27 million times 0.5553 is equal to 15 million, which brings us back to where we started. For more complex situations, begin by sketching the entire cash flow, where you might find a combination of elements: present expenditures at the start of the project, annual benefits, annual operations and maintenance, and perhaps a salvage value realized at the end of the project. Take care to convert each element individually until all elements are fully compatible, that all have been converted to their present value, alternatively, that all have been converted to their future value, or that all have been annualized. You'll perform these conversions using the appropriate factors. When faced with a non-integer discount rate, like 5.25%, you may be computing the factors from scratch using appropriate formulas like the ones shown here. When faced with geometric gradients, you will likely be computing the factors from scratch using appropriate formulas like this one here. There's plenty more to the science of engineering economics, but we've accomplished something here by covering the basics.